morning students, in our today's class we are going to start with the sexual reproduction in man. The way we have learned in plants, here also the reproductive phase is divided into three phases or events: pre-fertilization, that is which occur before fertilization, then fertilization which involves the fusion of gametes, that is sperm and ovum, and post-fertilization, that means development of embryo or a child from zygote, right? Now, we are going to learn about a special age, that is the puberty. Now, this is the period of sexual maturity, in very simple words. Period of sexual maturity means when the sexual organs develop and they start producing gametes. So, the sexual organ in male is testes, pair of testes. And as the individual or a boy reach puberty, then their growth is happening for the sexual part and they start producing the male gamete, that is the sperm. Same way, the females also have the puberty phase. They have the growth of their sexual organs, their body pattern changes, and they also start producing the female gamete, that is known as the ovum. For girls, the age of puberty is 10 to 12 years, and for boys, the puberty age is 11 to 13 years. Okay, now let us learn about the changes that occur in puberty, that is the age of sexual maturity. Now we have categorized these changes into three categories: common changes, that is they occur in both boys and girls, then there are some changes that occur only in boys, and some changes that occur only in girls, right? So the common changes that occur in both boys and girls are oily skin and pimples, then the thin growth of hairs on the body parts like arms, legs, chest, then thick hair growth in armpits and genital areas. These are the common changes that are seen in both boys and girls. Now in boys, the changes that are seen is the voice become low pitch, then the body becomes more muscular, they have got the broad shoulders, and beard and mustaches develop. So these are the changes that are seen only in the boys, whereas in the girls, the voice becomes high pitch, they start or they have a beginning of the sexual cycle, that is known as the menstrual cycle or menses. And they have the development of mammary glands or breast. Then they have the curving of the hip region or the pelvic girdle part. So these are the common changes that are seen in the girls. All these changes that you are seeing here, they are also known as secondary sexual characters, which basically develop as the child reach the age of puberty. The next topic for today's class is male reproductive system. Now, when we talk about the reproductive system is having the two type of parts, that is the primary organ and the second part is the ducts or the tubes. So, the primary organ is pair of testes, and this pair of testes is involved in the main function. That is, it produces the male gamete sperm, and it also produces the male hormone, which is testosterone. The production of sperm is known as spermatogenesis. Right? Now, testes children is located outside the abdominal cavity. It is present outside the abdomen. And it is present in a pouch-like structure that is known as scrotum. Why it is present outside the abdominal cavity? Because the process of sperm formation or spermatogenesis require the temperature that should be less than body temperature. At least 2 to 3 degree temperature should be less. That is, if your body temperature is 37 degrees C, then for sperm formation, the temperature required is either 34 or 35. That is why scrotum is a pouch in which testes is placed so that the process of spermatogenesis can occur. The next part is the duct. The duct includes these ducts or the tubes, that is epididymis, vasa deferens, urethra, penis. These are all the ducts. In common, they have function that either they are going to store the sperms or they are going to transfer the sperm from testes to outside. So now let us discuss these ducts one by one. The first duct is the epididymis. The main function of epididymis is to store the sperm, and here the sperm become mature and gain motility. That means it starts moving. Now the next duct is the vasa deferens. This is in pair and it is a long tube, and it basically carries the sperm from testes to urethra. Urethra is a duct through which the urine moves out. So, children, in male, the passage of urine and the passage of sperm occur through the common duct, that is known as the urethra. Now, the last part that you are going to learn is the penis. It is the male copulatory organ. Penis is the copulatory organ. Now, let us understand the meaning of copulatory. Copulatory organ means it is meant for deposition of sperm in the female genital tract, or the organ which is meant for transfer or receiving of the gamete. So penis is basically transferring the sperm to uterus of female or vagina of female, right? It is transferring the sperm from the testes to vagina of female. That is why it is known as the copulatory organ. So basically, this is categorized like this, and this is the complete depiction of the male reproductive system. For diagram, you can refer the NCRT. Okay, besides the male reproductive organs, there are few glands also that have important role to play in the reproduction processes. So in male, there are two glands, that is seminal vesicle and prostate gland. These both the glands are releasing a fluid, and the main function of this fluid is that it provides motility to sperm so that the sperm can be transferred, and the second important function is they provide nourishment to sperm. Now this fluid and sperm, when combined together, then it forms semen. The male ejaculate or release the semen outside the body. Okay, now let us learn the structure of male gamete in human, that is sperm. So this is the structure that is being drawn here. We are going to divide the sperm, which is a microscopic structure, into three main parts, that is head, middle piece and tail. Now the head of the sperm is covered by a cap-like structure that is known as sperm cap. The other name given to it is acrosome. Now this acrosome had got special role when the fertilization process has to occur. The head basically consists of nucleus, and since it is a gamete, so the number of chromosomes present in the nucleus is going to be haploid, that is N. The next part that you are going to see is the middle piece. The middle piece is having lot of mitochondria. These are mitochondria. Now what is the role of these mitochondria? These mitochondria produces energy, and that energy is used by the sperm to move, right? The next part is the tail. It has got a long tail, and this tail is basically helping in movement. So this is the structure of a sperm, which is the smaller gamete, microscopic structure. Then it is produced in millions in number. It does not have any reserve food material. See, we will learn ovum also as we will proceed in the chapter. So you must know that what are the differences between the male gamete and the female gamete. That is why I am telling that sperm are microscopic, they are motile, they do not have any reserve material or food in them. So that when you will compare with it ovum, then you will come to know the major differences. So this is the complete lesson for today. Thank you.